Guys, 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 it has happened yet again where a member of MK Party has left, a member of EFF has left EFF and joined MK Party. So I'm going to take you through that. Don't worry. There's another interesting story that I want us to cover here. And that story is Lalelan. So Uzondo, the former Chief Justice, causes out of office. He left the office on the 31st of August. There was a party that was thrown in there. They are accused of corruption. Oh, it's not me. Don't blame me. Don't. It's not what I say. It's what they say. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take you into confidence. So I'll show you everything one by one. They are accused of corruption. The party that was thrown for Zondo, it is marked by irregularities. It is marked by corruption. Oh, bongs. We talked to him, Fanagitile. Right. Those are some of the things that I want us to talk about in this specific video. But I want us to start with the issue of MK Party. So, yeah, to successfully do so, let me go through this. So I actually came across this. Let's start somewhere here. Yes, let's start somewhere here. It has been reported. Look, the former EFF national organizer and member of parliament from the Northern Cape has decided to follow in the footsteps of Floyd Chivambo by joining MK Party. Reports indicate that Floyd Chivambo is actively recruiting prominent EFF members who were not included on the party's parliamentary list to switch their alliance to the MK Party. Now, we heard from Malema himself that there's gonna be people that will join MK Party. He told us that some of those people who were not included in the list, blah blah blah, then they were going to join MK Party. So I kind of feel like maybe they did it intentionally to spite them, just to chase them away and say leave. You know what I'm saying? Because Malema was there saying leave now. So the news about the departure of this national organizer has been confirmed by the national organizer herself. So wait, don't rush. We're still going to talk about Justice Raymond, or former Chief Justice Raymond Zondo. Don't rush, Murife. Murife, don't run. Instead, do this.
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so this is where I want us to start. Right. Well, the person who her Twitter account, she confirmed that, listen, I have joined MK Commanders in my hometown of Kuruma Northern Cape Province, right? Mobilizing for the future and the generations to come. Let us all do so in our province, beyond its borders. No surrender. Right. Oh, she said it herself. She's gone. She's even wearing an MK Party. She's doing this in an MK Party regalia. She's saying we are going to mobilize somewhere. Ekurumane. Hey, angifuna abantu bathi mina bani wena uqhamba manga. This thing never happened. Well, bangakuphi la. Yiwuthoko lo. Apha amabelakhe. Ngimadoda. Yini le? Oh, all right. Speaking about look, Chief Justice Raymond Zondo, now, apha mangam. It says la, an article written by Thabo Makwakwa, IOL. It said it was published today. It says the office of the Chief Justice has denied a request to disclose the procurement and the financial details of the 2-day farewell party for the former Chief Justice Raymond Zondo. This followed concerns about the potential corruption, abuse of power, and mismanagement of funds by the head of OCJ, who allegedly approved the use of funds to organize a farewell party. Oh, my daughter. Oh, according to a source within the OCJ, there are concerns that the procurement policies were deliberately undermined as the farewell party for Zondo exceeded the usual amount allocated for such event. The farewell dinner in tribute to Zondo was held at Mantret Hotel, Melrose Arch in Johannesburg on August 20, 2024. The source alleged that the funds spent on the event far exceeded those for other retiring justices, and the procurement guidelines were overlooked. Oh, my God. One of the easiest ways to misuse the funds and not to be held accountable by anyone is to organize these kinds of ceremonies and put up all kinds of unverified figures. No one will ask or say anything because we are all excited by the party and forgot that some officials may be using our excitement to misuse the funds of the taxpayers, as so said. Okay. OCJ was approached by Sunday Independent to provide details for all procured services for the event, including the cost of the farewell party, the gala dinner, the venue, the transportation, the accommodation. However, the OCJ did not provide requested information. Instead, the OCJ said that it was not uncommon for the state to honor its high-profile citizens who dedicated their lives in service of the nation. During his term, Chief Justice Zondo has been pivotal in advancing the transformation of judicial, leading the Labor Appeal Court and the Constitutional Court, presiding over the State Capture Commission. So in other words, it qualifies us to spend as much money as possible because look at what the man has done. That's what the man is saying. Look, focus on what the man has done. The state capture, this. The man has done this. Do not, but they said, please provide us with facts so we can see how you spend the money, because these are public funds, right? These are not private funds. As we proceed, this is what they continue to say. The OCJ is firm of the view that the Gobertin is firm of the view that the two events held in honor of Chief Justice Zondo were proper, befitting, and appropriate to honor and acknowledge the Chief Justice for the 27th years of dedication into the nation and the judiciary, and to bid him farewell. That's what they are saying here. They're not answering the questions that people are asking. Therefore, the expenditure incurred in relation to these events are equal, proper, and in line with the conversation, practice, policy for such occasions and the stature of the office of Chief Justice. Have you noticed that the man hasn't answered the question? I don't know, maybe it's me, but what I've noticed is that they are saying, this is what the Sunday Independent, this is what we have sent you. We want you to answer 1, 2, and 3. Instead of answering 1, 2, and 3, what they do, they justify the expenditure and they don't provide because they have not provided the invoice. Instead, they are justifying the use of money. And when a person or any organization wants, even with the partner, by the way, let me tell you a story. I once caught a partner cheating because I could realize that every time you ask this person simple questions, instead of answering and providing facts, they start justifying their answers. And then I realized there's something more here. I'm telling you now, there's something more here. I will not be shocked if it's Sunday Independent. Crack the story and find even more evidence. I will not be shocked because look at the way this person is answering the question. They are not providing facts, but rather they are justifying the use of money without saying, okay, these are the invoice. This is how much we have used, but this is the reason for us to use this money. But they are not providing this, but they are justifying. The fact that they are justifying the use of money without providing facts, it's a worrisome. Believe you me when I say that. Let's proceed. Concerning the two former retired Chief Justice Mogoeng's decision relating to a farewell was respected. Ngcobo CJ's in terms of office ended before the OCJ was fully functional. National government department said the office of the head of OCJ. Now listen to this one. The lack of transparency and the failure to disclose the financial detail of the farewell party has raised concerns and questions about the use of public funds for such events. That's what I said to you, that this is public funds. Anything that is public, there must be transparency. Full stop. You don't start by justifying and then you expect people to believe you. No. You provide facts and then you justify them. I'm telling you, you should be worried that these people are not giving you answers, but they are justifying their answers. There's more. It leaves a lot to be desired. Believe you me when I say that. But let's proceed. Following many attempts to get the report report of the full list of the procurement of the services for the farewell party, this publication wrote to Parliament's Chair of Portfolio Committee on Justice and Correctional Development, Xola Ngcola, asking for his intervention in securing the information. Then, Sunday Independent World work here. He says, I will only be back to Parliament next week. We will follow up on all these issues when we are back in office, he answered. In August, Sunday Independent revealed that Secretary General and head of the OCJ allegedly appointed herself herself bodyguards at the expense of state without police assessment. Hey! Hi, Gubila. Gubila. Sources within the OCJ have said that it was unusual as the Chief Justice himself did not enjoy the same benefit afforded to Menese Watuati, who is accused of using her power to authorize the same benefit afforded to presiding officers of local officers and ministers. Hey, I Sunday World, they did a thorough job here. I enjoy reading this their article. It is alleged that Sir Jose Juane, as two protectors, are given access to irregular use vehicles that are allocated to the Constitutional Court. According to one of the senior employees who asked to remain anonymous, Sir Jose Juane protectors were hired by herself in July 2020 and have since been flying business class along their boss whenever she travels to Cape Town. Oh, at that time, the OCJ spokesperson said, rendering of protection service by the police fell within the ambit of their responsibilities, and the OCJ could not respond to questions about protection and services offered by the South African Police Service. Now, here's what worries me. You see, when corruption is happening in an institution that is supposed to prevent corruption, then this is the last office that you can think of corruption. Cannot be associated with corruption. It should not, it cannot be, because anything that is attached to judicial, it is deemed as last line of defense. So what happened when the last line of defense is accused of corruption? What do you... God, have mercy. The Judicial Administrative Manual Book on the Conditions and Benefit for Judges. The Chief Justice, Deputy Chief Justice, and Judge President are entitled to the same security measure as in their official readiness, similar to those allocated to ministers, deputy ministers, presiding officers. In July, publication revealed that Sir Jose Juane was reported to the Public Service Commission, which admitted that it had referred the matter to the Justice Department in 2022. The ministry did not respond to the question from the publication. What I find it interesting is how the article is written. Yeah, it's easy to read. It's so interesting. It's written in a manner that it's easy to follow as well. Should you wish to send your comment, please, here's an email address for this top journalist, investigative journalist, tabo.makwakwa@inl.co.za. Let me repeat the email here. tabo@inl.co.za. You probably have information that you want to send. What an interesting article. But I'm going to ask you this question. There's one question that troubles me the most, and that is, if this type of departments are accused of this corruption, then how can you trust the judicial when an office associated with the judicial is accused of corruption? I read this entire article intentional because I wanted to show you the details, how much they are confident at their story and the details that they give you and the answers that you are given here. It is like you are dealing with a person who, when they answer, they're like, you know what I'm saying? They're like, hey, you're man, man, man. That is exactly what you are getting, the answer that you are getting. But look at the work, guys, the investigative work. Wow. Top investigative journalism here. The writing style. It makes you want to read. It says, read more, 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 read more. Wow. Yeah, but let's forget about this good work. The writing and everything. The message that they are trying to send to you. Did you get it? If you don't get it, forget about it. If you don't get it, forget about it.